everybody, and welcome to the next episode of my Evolution of Halo concept art analysis series that I've been doing on this channel for about the past month. I really hope you guys have been enjoying these videos as much as I've been making them for you guys, and if you find yourself liking the video, be sure to drop a like on it because it helps the video reach more Halo fans, which is always a great thing. And whenever I sat down this evening to start making this video, I actually wanted to cover the analysis of a different species in the Covenant, but I stumbled across the concept art of the Flood, and I was like, I think I need to do the Flood, because these guys' concept art are so gnarly and crazy and actually quite hilarious that they skipped to the front. I'm making them, or at least covering the Flood combat form for you guys in this video, so I hope you guys enjoy. But let's dive into some crazy Flood combat form concept art before Bungie nailed down the final version that we saw on Halo Combat Evolved. So let's dive into our first piece of concept art with this thing. And this thing is actually kind of hilarious. First of all, where's his head? Where did the head go? What's wrong with this guy? He just like looks like a beefed up meat man. I don't know what this is, but okay, so let's dive in. So the first thing I obviously noticed is that this guy, he ain't got no head. I don't know where his head went, but after I looked at this guy a little bit, I finally figured out what he was, because I assumed that this was the Flood combat form of a human, but as you will see in the next piece of concept art, that actually isn't the case. But so looking at this guy, where did his feet go? It looks like the little feet are nubs, like all the way down to the bone. But one thing that is consistent with this guy that you actually see that are in the actual Flood combat forms in Halo Combat Evolved is this weird wormy looking texture that you see that like all over this dude's body. Like they're on his arms, they're on his chest. They're missing in places that make this dude look like he's wearing some crazy swimsuit. But either way, that's there. That's actually like the Flood crap that's in the actual final build of the game. But I have nothing else really to say about this guy, but this is wrong. Let's get to a better version. So moving on to our next piece of concept art with this guy, and though just as equally weird and wrong, there's actually quite a bit here that is actually in the Flood that you see in Halo Combat Evolved. Let's start with the things they got right first. First of all, the main Flood spore thing that you see in the spot of where this guy's head should be is kind of accurate, because when you look at a Flood combat formed in Halo Combat Evolved, there's always the main Flood spore area that has these tentacles shooting out, which is actually the Flood's weak spot. You shoot it and it kills the Flood faster, though it's located in Halo Combat Evolved right in the chest area. And obviously, okay, now think about if you were told to design the original Flood combat form for Halo Combat Evolved, and they told you to give the Flood this weak spot that has these tentacles coming out, where would you put it? Naturally, you think, well, I'll put it where the head is, because you shoot things in the head to kill them. And to me, it is far more creepy to have that tentacly weak spot right in the chest and to leave the head just mangled and dead laying over the shoulder. It is far creepier to do that than to actually have the Flood spore be the head, in my opinion, because it leaves the head and the head's just hanging there all dead and useless. And I just think it's far creepier the way they did it in Halo Combat Evolved than to do this. Now, that's what they got right. Now, what they got wrong is these big poofy sleeves. Like, I don't know what's going on with that. He just beefed up. He's been hitting the gym and just working his glamour muscles. I don't know what's going on. He's got some weirdness going on with his thighs too. But looking at this concept art and comparing it to the one that we saw a second ago, you can actually tell that this is not a human, because he's only got four fingers. Four fingers. And that, if you look at his feet, he doesn't have feet. He actually has hooves. So this is an elite. My point is that this is elite. The hooves give it away, and so do the four fingers. So this is obviously an elite concept art of the combat form of the Flood. And now we know that. So let's keep looking at this guy. He's wrong. And what I do actually find kind of interesting about this is he kind of looks like that big tanky looking Flood form that we'd see in Halo 3. I forget its name, but yeah, it kind of looks like that to me. But let's move on to the next piece of concept art with this guy. And I feel like this is pretty much the exact piece that we just saw. They took a little bit of the detail out of his arms, out of his poofy spots, his poofy sleeves and his big old poofy thighs, but they took some of the details away from that, but they decided, okay guys, we like this, but we want it to look more badass, so what do? So they gave him these big blades on his hands, and I'm like, as much as I'm like, yeah, the blades make it badass, you gotta get rid of them big, poofy looking sleeves, and it's just weird. So they ultimately scrapped this and moved on to the next thing, because though this is unique and kind of cool looking, I'm glad they did what they did, because it's just better in my opinion. So here we are at the fourth piece of concept art with this guy. And this is pretty damn close to the mark. This is obviously an Elite Combat form, as they, what I believe is pretty close to the final build of what we saw in Halo Combat Evolved. I believe this is probably the final phase of concept art for this character. Now, looking at him, it's what's one thing that they did that I really like that they changed from the previous concept art is that they decided to give the Elite pieces of armor. Instead of just like he's an Elite gets consumed by the flood spore, turns him into a flood, and just explodes out of all of his armor. It makes sense that some of his armor would fall off as he expands, not so much in the sleeve area, but it's cool because you can see that this Elite still has like his armor around his legs, a belt, some of his pants material is still there, and I've always thought that was cool that it didn't just completely rip out and like lose all of his uniforms. So it's cool that that's still there. This is actually the first time that we see throughout the concept art that this Flood is actually carrying a weapon that's not designed just to be melee. Though the Flood do melee you primarily as a form of attack in Halo Combat Evolved, it makes you wonder that when they were first designing the Flood, did they originally design them to exclusively melee you, that they had like the mindset of like zombies or something like that? But no, because obviously we know that they can shoot weapons, and it's in the concept art here that this guy clearly has a plasma rifle that this Elite was holding when he got consumed by the Flood. You also can see that they gave those weird tendrils on the end of his arm that he can use to just bitch slap the chief that he does in the campaign. That's something that we actually do see in the Flood combat forms, pretty much in all variations. So that's it. And now normally this would be the point in the video where I'd show you the final build of the combat form of the Flood, but I decided to show you some other things as well, because there's some stuff here that I found really interesting, and I'm saving that last one for the very end. Some of you guys might know this last thing if you've been following this series on my channel, but let's move on, because as you guys know, the Flood combat forms aren't just Elites, they are humans as well. So here we are at a piece of Flood combat form concept art for Halo Combat Evolved, and this is a human. This is the human Flood combat form. It's a very long name that I can't believe I haven't messed up yet. But here he is, and this is a really good example of what I meant. Like, having that Flood spore, that's the weak spot, that where all the tentacles are coming out, right there in, like, the chest or neck area. It's so creepy and weird to have it there instead of the head, because the head is still there, just twisted and mangled. In the previous concept art, I showed you the Elite. I didn't mention it, but his head is twisted going behind his back. The Elite has a longer neck, so they can actually hide it. But with the human, it's obvious that the head is just a piece of the anatomy that the Flood just isn't using necessarily, besides using like his, you know, thoughts and memories to build the grave mine. But it's just, that's so creepy to me. I hate it and I love it at the same time. He's also got the tendrils just like the Elite that we saw, but he's also got a weird version of the UNSC Magnum in his hand. You know, that's cool. But ultimately, this is pretty close to what we see in the final build of Halo Combat Evolved when it comes to the human combat form that we see with the Flood. Now, this last piece of concept art, I love showing this, because I've actually shown this in a previous concept art analysis video that I've already done on my channel, and I couldn't make this video without showing this. So if you haven't seen this, you're welcome. If you have seen it, here it is again. Guys, did you know when they were designing the Flood combat forms for Halo Combat Evolved, they designed a Flood combat form for the Grunt? Here it is. This is crazy. We would have seen a Flood combat form in Halo Combat Evolved if they had more time, or for whatever reason it was cut. It's not in the game, but they actually were drawing concept art for it, and it looks so good. I love how his head got literally twisted off and the Flood spore came out. That's wild. He's got, and his little tendrils look more like spikes than just whippy noodles that he slaps you with, but it's just so creepy and cool, and I love the idea. It didn't make it in the game. That's a shame. Maybe they'll add it into the future. Maybe Halo Infinite will have Flood, and if they do, maybe we'll see Halo combat forms of the Grunts. I don't know. I hope we do. But guys, we're at that point in the video where I can finally show you the Flood combat forms as they appear in Halo Combat Evolved, and here they are in all their disgusting, awful glory. Guys, I know when I was young, I actually hated fighting the Flood. I didn't like fighting the Flood in any of the main missions, but as I've gotten older and I love playing these campaigns, I actually miss them. I miss fighting the Flood. I actually do hope that they return in Halo Infinite. I mean, we're gonna be free roaming a Halo ring. Why not have like a containment unit that we can, you know, breach at some point in the story, and we have to shut it down, and it's just this thing. I just want to see the Flood. I want to see the Flood come back. Maybe I just want to see him back so we can finally get Flood Grunts. I don't know. But if that's the case, the concept art that you did like 20 plus years ago. It's pretty good. Use it because it's good. I love it. But either way, guys, that is the Flood concept art analysis video for the combat forums that we saw in Halo Combat Evolved. I can't believe I said that without getting tongue-tied, but I did a pretty good job, so I guess I'm gonna go ahead and end the video now. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did find yourself liking the video, be sure to drop a like on it because it helps the video reach more Halo fans, and it means a whole lot to me. You can't go wrong. I also make new Halo videos every single week, so be sure to subscribe so you don't miss any new videos. There's my mess up. Every single week. I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I'll catch you guys on the next one.